father, how did you like the overall effort, second and back to back tonight?
Well, yeah, I mean, I thought, especially in the third period, that we did a lot of willing, and you know, I mean, sacrificed and did, you know, and Alex was really good, I think, at handling the puck when they were getting it deep. He helped us an awful lot, so it was a gutsy win, I thought.
You said this morning that you're glass half empty with the power play. A little different now?
Full. It's just I can't have another drink. It was really good tonight, and it started to. I think that's 5 goals in the last 3 games. So, I mean, it's starting to come along. So that's a really positive sign.
Stahl made it sound like the tweak to put him in the middle just kind of happened by happenstance, and then they talked to Dean about it after he scored the goal a couple games ago. Is that pretty fair?
Okay.
That's not true.
No. Well, no, that's pretty well what Granny had suggested it.
Okay.
So we were holding off, and then when we were having some non-success, then we said let's change this thing. Mm-hmm. So we did, and it worked out.
You mentioned now, but along with the penalty kills, some key moments in this game, the 4 minutes in a row in the second period, that really made a difference. What did you see?
Well, our penalty killing has been really good all year. I mean, we're using 8 different players, and we could have used a 9th because, I mean, Eck didn't kill that much early on, and he's a really good penalty killer. So it's these guys that are penalty killing, I mean, they'll block shots, they sacrifice, they do the right things, and when you're doing that, and Bob's doing a good job of pre-scouting everything, so it's working out.
Nino's best game in a while?
Yeah, so I was really happy. For I was hoping he'd score an empty netter, but he gets 2 assists. The other things will come because he worked hard.
Bruce, when Mikhail Granlund is playing the way he is, I mean, what can you say about his dynamics as an offensive catalyst and him leading the charge during this 9 game stretch?
You know, I mean, I think if we were another city, whether it be a Canadian city or, you know, excuse me, a high profile city, that everybody would know how good this guy is. But he is our catalyst, and that's why he plays the most and why he's usually our leading scorer, because when you need something done, he's the guy that you want to have the puck.
Was this the response you were looking for from the top 6?
Yeah, I think so. Like, I mean, I think it was the response we were looking from everybody. I mean, I thought yesterday was a game that, you know, we could have won, we didn't. I don't know if we didn't take it seriously enough or it was the first game of the road trip or whatever, but I mean, they were determined tonight against a rested team that's was the hottest team in the league, so it was good effort.
Yeah, to go up against McDavid and see how easily he could turn a scoring chance out of nothing.
People of Edmonton are really lucky for the next 15 to 20 years. Man, that guy scares the crap out of you every time he steps on the ice. So, I mean, he's one heck of a hockey player.